Hello. Some of the best technology is invented during wartime. That's a fact, probably. The American space program was built around Nazi rocket technology. The first computer was created to decode German messages in 1944. Winston Churchill's cigar could hold up to 200,000 MP3s. Not definite about that last one. But my point is, a lot of the gadgets we use are born out of war, which is one good reason to be a soldier. Okay, so you risk your life fighting in horrendous conditions with no sleep and inadequate food, weapons and armour. But on the plus side, you might get to use a touchscreen before anyone else, or a jetpack. Like SkyGuard, a mobile missile defence laser system designed to intercept rockets. Yep, well, you've spent the last 5 years waiting for your broadband to go from 2 megabits to 2.2 megabits. Military engineers have been making real laser beams. And soon we'll probably have mini SkyGuards on keyrings that we can use for laser-accurate fly swatting. They've also been working on long-range acoustic devices. To you and me, that translates as massive speakers. They're designed for crowd control, these things, and pump out sound waves at 140 decibels, which is loud enough to permanently damage eardrums. Then there's continued research into the theoretical brown note, a frequency which can supposedly make an enemy soldier lose his lunch. Downwards, at 500 yards. Oh, I swear, there's a lad in my village who's already developed that technology and has pimped out Vauxhall Nova. I mean, don't get me wrong, I like incredibly bassy hip-hop as much as the next dog, if the next dog is Brian Sewell. Or what about the Israeli AirMule, a single-engine vertical takeoff and landing car plane type thing? It's basically a helicopter, but it's better than a helicopter because it looks like it's from Terminator 2. Or my personal favourite, the X-47B, a cutting-edge remote-controlled weaponised plane. Not a toy, this one's designed for combat. It can be flown into battle by a man sitting in a room with an Xbox controller, and soon we'll all have them and I can finally settle my neighbourly disputes with a good old dogfight. Which is why that one's my favourite piece of military technology. Basically, I don't like war, but I do like robots. Instead of claiming oil rights or gaining territory, warring countries get to come back the following week and try their military technology against Sir Killalot. Now, wouldn't that be better for everyone?